are your prophet. You have no defense because you're ashamed of your prophet.
Look at the mirror.
You're embarrassed of your prophet. That's
why.
All you can do is change the subject. Have you got a 6-year-old at home?
Listen.
Have you got a 6-year-old at home?
Someone else.
Have you got a 6-year-old at home? Have you got a 6-year-old at home? Have you got a 6-year-old at home? Have you got a 9-year-old at home? Have you got a 9-year-old at home? Do you dress in women's clothes like your prophet? Do you dress in women's clothes like your prophet? Do you wear eyeliner like your prophet? Do you? Are you proud of his behavior?
Yes, nice.
Are you proud?
Yeah, I'm proud.
Have you got a 6-year-old at home?
Yes, I do.
It's embarrassing.
Right, so do you want to answer?
When you walk past a 6-year-old, you have to put your head down. You have to put your head down when you walk past a 6-year-old. You have to go like this.
Let me
go. Shame. You have to do that. Do you have a 6-year-old at home?
Let's look at the dictionary definition of a paedophile.
Go on.
You can't answer.
You can't answer.
You will. Are you looking for a photograph? Are you looking for a photograph?
Oh, no.
It was a 9-year-old child.
No.
Disgusting.
You're lying.
That doesn't change anything.
This is the prophet of God. It's supposed to be a holy man. Supposed to be a holy man. Jesus is the only one that's holy.
Amen.
The only one that's holy, even your Quran says so, guys.
Let's look at the
think about it.
Hold on.
The common sense.
Wait, hold on.
He was born of a virgin.
Let's look at
Allah, who's supposed to be, he's supposed to love Muhammad, let him die of poison and save Jesus. Save Jesus.
Now, look,
Muhammad wasn't born of a virgin. Jesus was.
Okay.
Muhammad didn't do any miracles. Jesus did. Muhammad is dead, your sins. Jesus did it. Muhammad is dead. Jesus is alive.
Jesus died? So what's your point? I thought God doesn't die.
So what's your point?
God doesn't die. Hold on.
Numbskull behavior.
You don't make no sense. Wait.
I've just shown you.
You don't make no sense. You don't make no sense.
What's your point? What's your point?
Hold on.
I made about six.
I
made six.
Wait, hold on.
That's fine.
Wait, let me answer all six. Sorry. I will answer all six and I'll just put wipe it on the floor. Right? First of all,
you think I'm nuts? Would you like to come forward and defend your prophet?
Excuse me. He's doing that.
He's talking nonsense.
Talk to me. Talk to me.
Hold on. Are you willing to defend your prophet sleeping with a 6-year-old? Are you willing to defend your prophet sleeping with a 6-year-old?
Hello? The Bible says, I'm going to answer all six of your queries. Now, first of all, right, your Bible says in Psalm chapter 90,
defend your prophet! Defend your prophet!
Don't change the subject.
Defend your prophet! Your prophet! Your prophet was walking along one day and his best friend Abu Bakr had his little Aisha in his hand, in the Aisha in his hand, and Muhammad went, ooh, look at that kid. Oh, Abu Bakr, give me her. Abu Bakr, give me that child. Defend him.
The Bible says God can't die. The Bible says God can't die. You just said just now,
you're ashamed of your prophet.
That's a contradiction.
You're ashamed of your prophet. 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 You're ashamed of your prophet, aren't you? Are you proud? Are you proud of him? Are you proud? Are you proud? He wants to run. Are you proud? I'm proud of Jesus. Are you proud of Muhammad? He's not proud. This is a Muslim, but he's not willing to say he's proud of the best of mankind. Are you proud of Muhammad? Are you proud?
I'm
going for the heart of the snake. Muhammad.
Talk about this subject, I'm more than happy to discuss.
I asked last week, right, for one Muslim to come and defend their prophet sleeping with Aisha at 6-year-old. I'm still waiting. 1 week later, they can't say if they're proud. They can't say if they're embarrassed. They are in bondage. Believe in Jesus Christ. I'm trying to get to the root of the matter.
Ask him if he's proud of his prophet. I'm sorry, I'm not being funny, but he's screaming over me, and I can't even
answer.
Anyway, as I was saying, if we look at a dictionary definition of a paedophile, right?
Yeah.
paedophile.
Maybe this gentleman is willing to defend his prophet.
He's
really better. I can see you're really better. Do you want to step forward, sir? Let this man step forward. Let this man step forward.
Yeah.
How you doing?
I am well.
I see you're following your prophet in the way you look and so on. So are you proud of your prophet? You're proud of your prophet? Okay, that's a good start. Tell me why you're proud of him sleeping with a 6-year-old. Oh, right, let me rephrase that. Let me rephrase that. Desiring to marry a 6-year-old and sleeping with her when she was 9. Why are you proud of that?
Your question has a lot of presumptions.
Like a man.
There are a lot of presumptions in your question.
Aisha said, the prophet came and took me when I was 9 and I was playing with dolls. She was prepubescent. She hadn't had her period yet. She was still playing with dolls. She went to the prophet's house. And the prophet consummated the marriage before she reached puberty. What is good about that? Why are you proud of your prophet with such behavior? Evidence. Are you saying that I'm lying? Are you saying that I'm lying? I don't even want to bring the evidence. You know, I don't want to bring the evidence. This is very basic Islam belief. Because I've gone for the heart of the matter. And they want me to bring evidence. It's ridiculous. I'm not going
to
bring it.
I'm
asking you why you're proud of your prophet, my friend. Don't ask me for evidence. You know he did it.
Sir, you called me here for a discussion.
Okay.
This is not a discussion. This is a firing squad.
No.
If you want to
have a discussion. Do you feel like you're in front of the firing squad? Do you feel like you're in front of the firing squad? You should be.
You are.
Because.
Oh, it's you.
Because.
Are you with him? Hush.
Because I'm asking you about your prophet's behavior. I'm asking about your prophet's behavior.
You know people by the company they keep. The man is subliterate and you must be as well.
Have you got a 6-year-old at home?
You are subliterate.
Do you have a 6-year-old at home?
I found myself sucked into a discussion with subliterate.
Do you wear women's clothes? Do you follow your prophet? I see that you have a red beard like him.
You guys.
Do you wear eyeliner at home?
Not intellectually qualified.
Okay, you don't want to answer. You want to keep everything a secret?
Sir,
I follow Jesus in every way that I can. I fail miserably every day, but I love my enemies, so it doesn't matter. I'm proud of what he did because he was sinless. Are you proud of your prophet? Are you proud of your prophet?
To have a discussion with me. I know people, one Muslim.
Guys, I'm concerned for you. Because you should be able to step forward.
You
should be able to step forward and say, yes, I'm proud of my prophet. You
sit
with a child, I'll do the same thing. Who's willing to do
it?
Who?
None of you can't come up intellectually to this discussion.
Not one.
Maybe we should be telling
you. None of you Muslim.
Because we're talking about a 6-year-old. Maybe we need to come down to the age of 10, you know what I mean?
Defending people with a 6-year-old. Don't ask me for evidence. Don't ask me evidence and insult my intelligence. You know it's true. So defend him.
What does that say though? Don't push me.
Just keep your cool.
Mary was 12.
Look what you're trying to argue with now. You're far from ready. You're calling me. You're calling me.
Okay. Honest, from the heart, sincerity, I mean that, no joke, right? But I've asked you a question.
Yeah, I'm proud of my prophet.
Are you proud that he's...
I'm proud of my prophet.
Okay.
That's what you're asking.
All right, no, there's a specific. Are you proud that he slept with a 9-year-old child?
He did not sleep with a 9-year-old. Denial.
I want someone to come and admit that it happened and then be proud. Don't come and deny it and say you're proud.
Where's your hadith? So if we give you the hadith,
you're shouting though. How am I going to?
Okay, my voice will be raised so that everybody can hear me. I want a Muslim to come and defend their prophet and say I'm proud. He slept with a 9-year-old child. He's the best example. I will do the same thing.
Best of examples.
Who's willing to do that? And if no Muslim is willing to do that, that means you're all ashamed of him. You're all ashamed. Every Every one of you is a shame. All you're practicing it at home. All you're practicing it at home. All you're practicing it at home.
You have a debate with me. Why did you run away from me last time? You promised debate.
Okay, debate.
You want to change the subject?
Okay, you're debating. Aki, say the debate.
Listen, hold on, I should owe this man an apology.
Yeah, okay.
Because he came to me and he told me that I promised him to debate a few weeks ago, and I said I didn't, but when I watched the video, I remembered I did. So, yeah, I have my apology for that. Because I did.
That's why, man.
So can you just apologize? He's calling me a liar.
I'm here.
They're trying to stick something on the Christian.
Desperation.
I know it's desperation. So, listen.
Half an hour in.
Listen. Yeah, let's round it off. I've asked for about a half an hour. I'm tired now. Because no Muslim is prepared to come in front of the camera and say I'm proud of my prophet that he slept with a 9-year-old child. They are secretly embarrassed or secretly perverted. This is why you need to come to Jesus Christ. The way, the truth, and the life. He loves you. He died for you. Give your life to him and live forevermore. Hallelujah.